Yes, in this video, we are going to see how to traverse a doubly linked list. A doubly linked list, you can traverse both in the forward direction and in the backward direction by using the previous and the next field. So, in the next field, you have the next node memory location. The previous node, you have the previous node memory location. So, let us take this, consider this linked, this doubly linked list. Now, according to the algorithm, the name of this function is traverse, and then we declare a temporary pointer called temp, and this is made to point to the head by this statement. Then now it is pointing here. Now while down, you are going to move only this. While temp is not equal till it reaches the end of the node, that can be achieved by checking while temp is not equal to null. Then in this while loop, you print the data field whatever is present. Then you move this temp equal to point to the next node, and so on till it reaches the null, so that the whole data, the whole linked list is traversed and the value present in the data can be printed. Now we will see the reverse printing. Here we have to start, we have to take this tail and then we move backward. So here initially temp is made to point to tail. So here what we do is we are making this to point here initially. So here according to this statement, temp is made to point to the tail. Then while temp is not equal to null, yes, here also the previous is a null. So till it reaches the null, then you print the value 30, 20. So by the time it is made, temp is made to point to the temp previous, which is nothing but 101. Then it is printed, the value is printed. Then temp is made to point to the previous node, which is nothing but 100. Now again temp is made to previous, which is nothing but now null. So when it reaches null, it comes out. Now we are going to search for an element in a doubly linked list. So given the value, let us imagine 20. Now we are going to search for that. So here we pass the data 20, and then we temporary, as usual, temporary pointer we use, which is of type node type. Then initially it is made to point to the head. Then we keep a count, because in which node it is present that we would like to print. So we keep a count. Then while temp is not equal till it reaches the end of the list, you search the value. If temp data, so here, if temp data is equal to the Q data, that is the one which we want to know. Let us imagine we are passing 20. So here it is not matching. It is not equal to. If it is equal to, then the while loop will be broke, and then the value will be printed and or it will be returned to the main program. So here, here it is not. So what happens? The next statement. Yeah, it will not go inside the if class. So the temp equal to temp next. Now this is pointer is moved here. Now when it is moved here, what happens? Here 20, Q data is 20. Now it is matching. Okay, now it go inside return count. Already count is 1. And here because of this, count has become 2. That is the second node we are able to get the data. So count plus plus. Now what happens? Since it is equal to Q data, return the count. This value 2 will be returned and it break. It will not go through the whole of the linked list, since the one which you are the data which you are searching we have found, and the position will be returned to the main program. Suppose when it becomes, suppose I am searching for 35, then it goes here, temp become null. So that what happened here, it is not able to find 35 is not at all there, so it return a 0. Now we'll see update. I want to update a value, so I am passing old data as well as the new data. So what happens here, when you pass, we are again using a temporary pointer and we make that head temp to point to the head, and we are moving. So here we are searching till it is not equal to null, whether temp data is equal to old data. If it is there, if max, say for example I want to change 20 to 25, so if it is equal to null, then temp data la, we put that new data, then return 1, success. So return 1. Then ill or else, the first it is 10, it is not matching, so temp equal to temp next, and so on. So this is made to point to the next location. So whenever it defines a match, it comes on break and it return a 1. Now this is a destroy list. I want to destroy the whole linked list, doubly linked list. So how to do that? Again we use a temp. You can just unlink the head and tail so that you will no more access. But what happens to the nodes? That has to be removed. Then only it is the destruction. So what we do is we keep a temporary pointer. Well, then we move the head itself so that we lose all the pointers. So while head is not equal to null, temp equal to, initially temp is made to head, and then we move head to point to this. So after this, it will be here. Now temp is pointing this. Now you execute the delete temp. Now this will be removed. And after that, the head is made here and the temp is made here. According to this statement, temp is made to point to the head, and then the head is made to point to the next. And then again, now head temp is pointing this. Now you delete. And then and so on till it becomes null. So that when this over, the whole node will be deleted. All the nodes in the doubly linked list will be deleted. They will be removed of the memory they have used.